Okay, so moving on to the share pod where we can share PowerPoints, our desktop, and a whiteboard. So first off, again, let's go back into our meeting and we see here the share pod. And this is a drop-down box, share my screen. If you hit the drop-down arrow, that's where you have the options for sharing screen, sharing document, and sharing whiteboard. We recommend that if you share PowerPoints to use the share document. If you share Excel sheets or Word documents, that's where you need to share my screen, okay? That's where it's compatible with. First off, let's go ahead and demonstrate how to share a PowerPoint. So you go to share document, and if you've uploaded it beforehand or a time or two, it's going to show up in the recent history. If not, again, it shows that I don't have anything here. You just go to browse your computer and open up one where you have one located. We recommend that you use PPTs as opposed to PPTXs. I'm gonna go with one here. I have a PPTX. Again, I know that this PPTX will work, but again, we recommend PPT just because of fonts, animations, and things like that. So once you select one and you open it after browsing, it's gonna show up here saying Adobe Connect, your PowerPoint is converting, all right? Give it a second, and if you've converted it once, it won't take as much time the next time to open up. Remember, the longer your PowerPoint, the longer it will take to convert. Okay, this right now is only about a 10 to 12 slide PowerPoint, and again, it didn't take that long to upload and convert. So, this is what it looks like to your participants and you. Your participants right now are seeing the talking head, they're seeing this entire template, okay? And that's fine. They will see the talking head and they'll see the attendees list, the chat. And again, remember, if you don't want them to see the attendees list at any time or for a while, you can hide that if you want. You can hide the chat box if you want to, but then that takes away you able to see it as well. Just FYI, okay? Now I'll go ahead and bring those back. That was the chat. Bring up the chat and bring out my attendees list. There we go. Okay. A few things with the PowerPoint. Again, once we actually convert the PowerPoint, the way you advance and go back are your arrows here on the bottom left. All right, and simple enough, you just go ahead and click them that way. Okay. If you want to show the sidebar, you hit that icon right there, and you can go specifically straight to one of the PowerPoint slides. All right, if you don't want it, you can actually just hit that back again, and there you go. It's full view. And the next thing I guess to know would be these two functions up here, the draw and arrow feature. Yes, you have my mouse icon that might work, but if you want to grab the attention of your participants, you can go ahead and move the green arrow around to wherever you are talking about to kind of keep them in focus. Again, that's just a little simple little feature. If you want to draw, if you want to make some notes on your PowerPoints, well, you go to the draw button, and down here is where it provides you with some extra tools. Okay, here is the selection tool, pencil, pretty self-explanatory, the eraser, and the text box. Those are your main four that you'll probably need for right now. Notice how you cannot select the eraser right now. That's the only tricky thing about drawing on your PowerPoints or using the whiteboard and things like that in Adobe Connect. You have to use the selection tool and then erase, which I'll show you here in a second. Say you are here and you want to make some notes. Okay, well, get your pencil there. You can select, what color you want to use, how thick you want your pencil to be, and there you go. I'm drawing with the mouse. Okay, this is where if you had a tablet PC, making notes would really come in handy. Again, having a tablet PC if you have it. If your department supplies them or whatnot, using a whiteboard or using it to mark up your PowerPoint and save those notes, like this, a tablet PC would come in handy, or some type of device where you can actually physically write with a stylus. Okay. So you have that right there. Say, this is for face-to-face, online, and you're happy with that. So notice if you move on, all right. Your markings will go away. But say, wait a minute, I forgot to tell you something very important. you go back and you say they're also for on-demand environments. So when you go back to it, your markings will be there. Say you don't want your markings though, okay? Say you want to erase. That's where I told you that's a little tricky. Go to the selection tool, okay, and then you have to point and create a box. So you click and drag over your entire markings. See how then it creates a box with your markings in it? Then that eraser comes forward. And then all you gotta do is click on it and erase. All right, so you, again, selection tool. Let me make a marking for you. Let me make several markings. All right, so then you go to selection tool, click away from it, make a big box around it all, which is you just click on the open area and then you drag like a corner and see how it highlights everything, brings up the eraser, you hit the eraser, and it goes away. Okay? So that is how you can make notes on your PowerPoint. If you want to stop sharing your PowerPoint, then you would just hit stop sharing. I will tell you right now that once, if you say you stop right here, okay, and you stop sharing, it goes back to the share screen and then no one can see it. Say you go back to share document, notice how my PowerPoint is still up there, you hit okay, it brings it back to right where you left off, just FYI. So if you need to go back to the beginning, you can. And there you go. And I will stop sharing that. The next thing we will talk about is sharing a whiteboard. Okay, again, comes in handy for if you have a tablet PC or some device that you can actually write on with a stylus or maybe even with your fingers, better than with a mouse. Same concept though, you click on the pencil and I will write hello with the mouse. If you do not want to use it, you select your tool, selection tool, highlight it all, and then you hit erase. All right. Text box. If you want to place your text box somewhere, you can choose your font size, the type that you have there, make it bigger. Hello. Welcome. Okay, same thing. If you do not want to use it, selection tool, highlight it, and then hit erase. Okay, and it'll come pretty quick after you get used to the way of having to select the selection tool after if you want to erase the text box or any type of annotations you make with pencil. So, again, that's the whiteboard, pretty self-explanatory. If you want to stop sharing it again, you just come up to stop sharing. It'll go back to there, and this will pop back up again. And all they will see is if you have the webcam activated, the webcam. If not, they will see your meeting session with nothing being shared. Next up, we actually have the last one called Share My Screen. This one is a little bit, it's not tricky, but you have to keep in mind that once you share your screen, it's going to ask you desktop, applications, or Windows. Recommend that you share desktop, okay? Because then if you have to go back and forth from a web page to a Word document or Excel, you can go ahead and just maneuver around like you normally would. So we recommend desktop. If you have dual monitor like I do, it's going to ask you first monitor or second monitor. So I'm going to go ahead and select second monitor because that's where my meeting room is right now. And if you only have one monitor, it's going to show up like this. So if I hit second monitor, share, okay, notice that you do not see the meeting room anymore. Keep in mind, your participants, your students do, okay? You do not see it, but you have to be diligent enough to remember that they still see you on webcam if you have it on, and they still see the webcam pod, the attendees pod, the chat pod, along with your desktop, okay? And we'll show you that when we go into manipulate the recording after we get done with this. So, we have here is your desktop, and they see what you are doing on your desktop. So, say I pull up a Word document, okay? There's my Word document. You can go through there and just, again, maneuver however you need to, okay? Same thing with Excel sheets. Say I need to go to the website, a web page, and you can just have them follow along. A lot of instructors do like the fact use this capability for browsing the web, say for the library, how to search the databases. Okay, this is a good way to show them how, and again, it's kind of on demand. You know, your student's like, oh, I can't remember how to go to this database. Can't remember how to maneuver around the library's webpage. So they can be like, oh, I can go to this recording, and you know, my professor has shown me how to do so. And so you can just, again, maneuver around like you normally would with Share My Screen. Again, just remember that even though you do not see the webcam, the chat pod, and the attendees pod, and the share pod, they do. Okay, within that share pod, instead of seeing like you would see that PowerPoint, they see your desktop, but they also see those other pods. You do not, but just remember, they're there, and they're recording. And another thing is, notice how you don't see those pods that I mentioned, but if someone had a question in a live meeting, in the right-hand, bottom right-hand corner, I do believe, you know, it would say again, John Doe says, and he might be chatting something, please, you know, go into further detail. Say someone raised their hand, you would see those type of things. So once you do that, after you share your desktop, say you are wanting to stop sharing your screen. Well, that case, that's where you pop this back up. Now remember, you're still sharing your screen, so they're actually seeing this pod, and then in this sharing area, they are actually seeing the pod again. Okay, it could get really confusing, really crazy looking. So just remember, you need to go ahead and stop sharing. Once you stop sharing, they're going to see this again. They're going to see this blankness in here. Okay, keep in mind. All right. So we've went ahead and we've discussed the share pod a little more in detail. Next, we will show you how to end the meeting and go in and set up the information on the recordings and how to make it public.